Hello friends, today we will learn about history of pharmacopoeia in brief with special reference to Indian pharmacopoeia. So first we will understand what is pharmacy. Okay. So pharmacy is the science or practice of the preparation and dispensing of medicinal drugs. Okay. Means in pharmacy education we learn about the discovery, production, control, disposal, safe and effective use of medicine. Okay. Now let us see what is pharmacopoeia. Pharmacopoeia, the term pharmacopoeia comes from the Greek word pharmakon meaning drug and poiein meaning to make. And the combination means any recipe or formula to other standards required to make or prepare a drug. Okay. Means the pharmacopoeia describes the formula and other standards for a and the combination means any recipe or formula to other standards required to make or prepare a drug. Okay. Means the pharmacopoeia describes the formula and other standards for a particular medicine. So while preparing any medicinal product, the standards described in pharmacopoeia must be followed. Okay. So pharmacopoeia is a legal and official book of directions and requirements for the preparation of medicines issued by recognized authority, usually appointed by government of each country. Okay. Means pharmacopoeia is actually a book, okay, in which directions and requirements for preparation of medicines is given. Means it is a legislation of a country which sets standards and obligatory quality indices for the drug. Pharmacopoeia consists of three main sections. First one, introduction and general notices. Second one, monograph of the drug. And third one, appendices. Now we'll see what is monograph. Monograph is a complete description of a specific pharmaceutical drug or product which includes nomenclature, classification, physical characteristics, dosage, purity, limits for impurities, identification, assay and condition for storage. Means monograph is a whole description of the drug and standards required for the any drug or preparation, okay, which is given in the monograph. So let us take a brief account of some important pharmacopoeia. So in the United States, the first pharmacopoeia was published in December 1820, both in English and Latin. So first USP, US pharmacopoeia was published in 1820. Later on, a national formulary was published in addition to USP. The first British pharmacopoeia was published in 1864. And another important pharmacopoeia, that is International Pharmacopoeia, was published by World Health Organization in two volumes. First volume was published in 1951 and second volume was published in 1955. So the object of this International Pharmacopoeia was to provide a uniform list which would avoid the confusion caused by different national standards, strengths and names, especially for the use of travelers who might need to use the same prescription in different countries. So here there is list of certain important pharmacopoeia. For example, Argentine, Austrian, Belgian, Brazilian, British pharmacopoeia and many more. Okay. So among all these pharmacopoeia, British pharmacopoeia, European pharmacopoeia, Indian pharmacopoeia, international pharmacopoeia and United States pharmacopoeia are of more important. Now we will see in brief history of Indian pharmacopoeia. So in pre-independence days, British pharmacopoeia was employed as the official book in India. That means before independence, the medicines in India were prepared according to British pharmacopoeia. Means standards given in British pharmacopoeia were followed for preparation of many medicines. The actual process for preparation of Indian pharmacopoeia started in 1944. Okay. The government of India on 26 January 1944 directed the Drugs Technical Advisory Board to list the drugs used in India which are not mentioned in British pharmacopoeia and also recommend the standards to be prescribed to maintain uniformity and the chemical tests to be used to establish identity and purity. Okay. So Government of India asked Drug Technical Advisory Board to prepare a list of the drugs and their standards required which are not included in the British pharmacopoeia. So the Indian Pharmacopoeia List Committee, Indian Pharmacopoeia List Committee was prepared under the chairmanship of Dr. Sir R.N. Chopra along with other 9 members and they prepared the Indian Pharmacopoeia List. It was prepared by the Department of Health, Government of India in 1946. So first Indian Pharmacopoeia List was prepared in 1946. As a supplement to British pharmacopoeia. In Indian pharmacopoeia list contain 180 monographs and a number of appendices prepared on the line of British pharmacopoeia. Approximately 100 monographs were on vegetable drugs growing in India. The drugs of plant origin such as cannabis, rawalpia, wasaka, etc. were included in it. Similarly, several oils such as ajwain, cassia, neem and pudina were included in pharmacopoeia list. After the publication of Indian pharmacopoeia list, the Government of India constituted an 11-membered Indian pharmacopoeia committee in 1948 for preparing the pharmacopoeia of India. Since before this, we were using British pharmacopoeia as a standard. In 1948, the committee was constituted called Indian Pharmacopoeia Committee to prepare a pharmacopoeia of India. And the tenure of committee was 5 years, which was extended by 1 year in 1953. And Dr. B.N. Ghosh was appointed as the chairman. So in compiling the monograph of the first Indian pharmacopoeia, help was taken from British Pharmacopoeia, US Pharmacopoeia and International Pharmacopoeia products. So under the chairmanship of Dr. B.N. Ghosh, the first edition of Pharmacopoeia of India was compiled and published in 1955. The first edition of IP was published in 1955 under the chairmanship of Dr. B.N. Ghosh. Under the Drugs and Cosmetic Act 1940, the Indian Pharmacopoeia is a legally recognized book of standards for quality of drugs and their preparation. Another important commission which is involved in preparation of Indian Pharmacopoeia is Indian Pharmacopoeia Commission. Government of India established a separate dedicated autonomous institution. It is a separate autonomous institution called as Indian Pharmacopoeia Commission in 2005 at Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh, which is headquartered in Ghaziabad, Uttar Pradesh. Okay. So IPC is an autonomous institution of the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare of Government of India, which sets standards for all the drugs that are manufactured, sold and consumed in India. So IPC is a autonomous body under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare of Government of India which sets standards for the drugs to be manufactured and sold and consumed in India. So IPC became fully operational from January 2009. So before IPC, Indian Pharmacopoeia Committee was publishing the Indian Pharmacopoeia. After formation of IPC, The sixth edition of Indian Pharmacopoeia 2010 was published by IPC. Before IPC, Indian Pharmacopoeial Committee was publishing the IP. So we'll see the editions of Indian Pharmacopoeia. Total 8 editions have been published up till now. The first edition of Indian Pharmacopoeia is published in 1955 and the supplement for the same was published in 1960 under the chairmanship of Dr. B.N. Ghosh. Second edition was published in 1966 with the supplement in 1975 under the chairmanship of Dr. B. Mukherjee. Third edition was published in 1985 in 2 volumes and addendum was added in 1989 and 1991. And this IP 1985 was published under the chairmanship of Dr. Nityanand. Fourth edition was published in 1996, which is also included 2 volumes, and for this 3 addendums were added, addendum in 2000, then veterinary supplement in 2002 and addendum in 2005 were added under the chairmanship of Dr. Nityanand. Fifth edition editions have been published up till now. The first edition of Indian Pharmacopoeia is published in 1955 and the supplement for the same was published in 1960 under the chairmanship of Dr. B.N. Ghosh. Second edition was published in 1966 with the supplement in 1975 under the chairmanship of Dr. B. Mukherjee. Third edition was published in 1985 in 2 volumes and addendum was added in 1989 and 1991. And this IP 1985 was published under the chairmanship of Dr. Nityanand. Fourth edition was published in 1996, which is also included 2 volumes. And for this 3 addendums were added, addendum in 2000, then veterinary supplement in 2002 and addendum in 2005 were added under the chairmanship of Dr. Nityanand. Fifth edition also published under the chairmanship of Dr. Nityanand in 2007, which consisted 3 volumes and addendum 2 was added in 2008. After 5th edition, Indian Pharmacopoeia Commission became active and 6th edition of that is IP 2010 was published in 3 volumes by IPC and addendum was added in 2012. 7th edition was published in 2014 in 4 volumes and addendum was added to in 2015 and 16. While 8th and latest edition is published in 2018 in 4 volumes and addendum to 8th edition was added in 2019. So 6th, 7th and 8th edition was published under the chairmanship of Secretary, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Okay. So first 5 editions were published by Indian Pharmacopoeial Committee. And after Indian Pharmacopoeial Committee, a separate autonomous body, that is Indian Pharmacopoeia Commission, started to publish the Indian Pharmacopoeia. So 6th, 7th and 8th edition were published by Indian Pharmacopoeia Commission under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare of Government of India. Okay. So these are the total 8 editions of IP which are published till date. Okay, last edition is published in 2018. So we'll these are the photographs of some IP. Colors also changed when the edition is changed. So we'll see certain salient features of latest edition, that is Indian Pharmacopoeia 2018. Okay, it is having orange color. New 220 monographs are added in to 2018, 366 revisions and 7 omissions are carried out. 170 new chemical monographs are added, which included 49 APIs, 64 formulations, 53 fixed dose formulations, 2 excipients and 2 antibiotics. Again, 15 new herbs and herbal products are added in IP 2018. 3 new radiopharmaceutical monographs are added. 14 new veterinary non-biological monographs are added. And 18 new biological monographs are added in 2018. Okay. These 18 biological monographs includes 2 vaccines and immunosera for human use, 6 biotechnology derived therapeutic products and 10 blood and drug related products. Standards for new drugs, drugs under National Health Program and drugs in National List of Essential Medicines have been included in IP 2018. Then the Addendum 2019 is added to Indian Pharmacopoeia 2018. Okay. So this addendum consists of 66 new monographs including chemicals, herbs and herbal products and radiopharmaceutical preparations. 1 general monograph on lotion is also included in addendum 2019. Special emphasis has been given to the dosage forms of API whose dosage forms were not in the IP 2018. General chemical tests for identification of an article have been almost eliminated and more specific infrared, ultraviolet spectrophotometric HPLC and HPTLC tests have been given the emphasis in addendum 2019. Special emphasis was given to include upgrade dissolution test in existing monographs. Most of the existing assays and related substances tests have been upgraded to liquid chromatographic method. So for assay of drugs, most of the drugs, liquid chromatographic method is employed in addendum 2019. Okay, so this is all about IP, Indian Pharmacopoeia. Okay. Thank you.